car industry is a tough one, and developing and building a car, at least a good one, requires time and money. That's why projects are planned even to the smallest detail. Design, engineering, researching, regulations that at least used to change country to country. There are so many reasons for a project to go wrong, and so many reasons for a project to be cancelled before seeing the day of production. And this is quite devastating, since sometimes these cars are just amazing, and in some cases could have saved companies, changing this way their history. To be clear, I'm not talking here about concept show cars, but about cars that from the beginning were developed with the idea that one day would go into production. So hello guys and welcome back to another video, and here are amazing cancel cars. From the beginning, the Lamborghini lineup was made out of at least two cars, the main mid-engine V12 and a second car, which originally was the Grand Tourer, the car that competed head-to-head with the Ferraris of the time. But later this second car evolved into a second mid-engine, which was the entry-level Lamborghini. By the mid-80s, Lamborghini was struggling a lot. The lineup was made out of three cars, the Alpha, the LM002 and the Countach. And everything would culminate in 1987 when they were acquired by Chrysler. With the new leadership, things changed a lot for Lamborghini. The first thing was that the Alpha was discontinued after only 7 years on the market. The car had extremely poor sales compared to the rivals of Porsche and Ferrari. And with both Mercedes and BMW, and also with a new wave of Japanese sport cars, Lamborghini had no other option but to build a new car for the 90s. The P140 project started in 1988 and followed on the footsteps of the P132 project, which was the Countach replacement. By the time that Chrysler bought Lamborghini, the development of the Countach had already started. The car should have been ready by the time, but due to some design flaws, the date was postponed. And since Chrysler wasn't happy with the design of the 132, the design was postponed even further. Both the 132 and the 140 were designed by Marcello Gandini. In a sort of way, Gandini had created the Lamborghini identity, first with Miura and later with Countach. But by the 80s, his designs had started to show their age, and because of this, both designs received some changes. The 132 was trusted to Tom Gale, while the P140 was trusted to Horacio Pagani, which also had been responsible for the 25th anniversary Countach. Later, Horacio would also be involved in another project called L30. Which was meant to celebrate the 30th anniversary of Lamborghini. As we know, the L30 never made it into production, but the car would be the basis for the Zonda when Horacio would create his own company. For the engine, Lamborghini had no other option but to build a new one. The V12 was of course out of equation, while the V8 just was too old and not good enough for the new decade. And so, in only 7 months, Lamborghini engineers managed to build a totally new V10 Quattrovalvole with an electronic fuel injection system. The engine was capable to produce 400 horsepower, and thanks to the lightweight construction, the 140 could reach a top speed of over 300 km per hour. and had an acceleration time of 5 seconds. The car looked really promising, and Lamborghini believed that they could build up to 1,000 cars per year. Lamborghini continued to develop the P140 until 1992, when they decided to cancel the project. Now, there were a number of reasons why this project was cancelled. First were the economic crisis of the time, especially in the Middle East. Another reason was that the design just was the 90s. But most importantly was the stage of Chrysler by this time, which was in big financial troubles. And so, in an attempt to save as much money as possible, Chrysler sold Lamborghini to the Malaysian group Maicon Setco and to the Indonesian group V-Power for just $40 million. In 1995, Lamborghini would go and present the Kala, which was the evolution of the P140. Underneath, the cars were basically the same, just that Kala came with a much more modern design. No one can say for sure if there were any real plans to put this car into production. This part of Lamborghini history is very mysterious, with many shady deals behind closed doors. But in 1998, Audi bought Lamborghini for $110 million. They decided to cancel all the projects that Lamborghini was running at the time. But in the end, they followed the idea of a baby V10 Lambo with the Gallardo.